بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Welcome to Q&A by Sheikh Muhammad Al-Salih Al-Uthaymeen. Segment number 6, which is a continuation to the previous question concerning the messengers and preferring one over the other. Allah the Almighty is saying in the Quran, آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله. سورة البقرة سورة نمبر 2 verse 285. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم had believed regardless what been revealed to him from his Lord, as well as the believers. All, that means the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as well the Sahaba, believe in Allah, his angels, his books, his messengers. We did not make any difference. We don't distinguish between any of the messengers of Allah. So the Sheikh rahmatullah alayhi saying, فلا نفرق بين أحد من الرسل في الإيمان به وأنه صادق مصدوق ورسالته حق ولكن نفرق في أمرين. We did not make any difference between any of the messengers concerning the belief. That means we believe in all the messengers. And we believe that all of them are truthful. And we believe that all of them convey the message. But we distinguish between the messengers and the prophets in two matters. Okay? Pay attention, because some people get confused. You say, how you can say the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam better than all the prophets? And Allah is saying in Quran, لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله, that we did not distinguish between any of the messengers. So the Sheikh is saying that we did not make different in matter of belief. That means we believe in all of them. They are the messengers of Allah. They are truthful. They convey the message. But we make a distinguish between the prophets in two things. Number one, الأفضلية, excellency. Okay? We prefer some of them over the other. Due to the fact that Allah had preferred some over others. Allah had raised some of them more in ranks. But we did not say this out of arrogancy or talking bad about other prophet. This prophet is better than this. That means that the other prophet is nothing. Okay? But we believe that some of them are better than others, and that Allah had raised some of them more than others. Okay? But does not mean this one is a messenger and this one is nothing. Is a righteous man and this it. Okay? That mean not to show any disrespect or undercut the other one. As it came in the collection of Imam al-Bukhari, that a Jew, he swore and said, nay, by the one who chose Moses upon all mankind. A man from Ansar heard him and he slapped him on his face when he heard him and say, you dare saying this? How you dare saying this? While the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam Muhammad is still living among us. The Jew man went to the Prophet Muhammad and say, I had a treaty. I have a confidant. I have a pledge. I have a protection under your jurisdiction, okay, that somebody transgress against me. This man, he slapped me on my face. The Prophet ﷺ said to the man from the Ansar, why did you slap him in his face? So he told him what happened. The Prophet ﷺ became so angry until we recognize and realize the anger on his face. And then he said, don't prefer between the prophets of Allah. And also it is reported by Abu Huraira radiallahu an, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا ينبغي لعبد أن يقول أنا خير من يونس ابن متى. No one supposed to say that I, means the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, better than Jonah, son of Matthew. Okay? So we believe the prophets have a different higher degree than others, and that Allah gave some more than others, and some elevate, Allah elevates some over others. This part of our belief, but we are not supposed to sit and degrade other prophets or saying this out of disrespect to other prophets. Okay? The second issue that we make difference between the Prophet concerning al-ittiba', who do you follow? The second way of distinction between the prophets, that we don't follow anyone except the one that been sent to us, which is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That because his law, his book, his Sharia had abrogated all the laws and all the books that had been sent before. As Allah said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse number 48, وَأَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَمُهَيْمِنًا عَلَيْهِ فَاحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهِ ولا تتبع أهواءهم عما جاءك من الحق لكل جعلنا منكم شرعة ومنهاجا. Allah Almighty is saying what the meaning is. Indeed, we reveal to you the book, O Muhammad, with the truth and confirm what been revealed before from the book, and have authority over the other revelation, other books. So judge between them according what Allah revealed to you, and don't follow their desires after the truth had came to you. For every nation we make a Sharia and way. So here two things we understand from this verse. What Surah Ma'idah is what? Number 5, verse number 48. Remember, 548 is saying what? That the book to confirm what been revealed before, and what? And to have haymana, have authority, like a checkout, have the authority to tell you what's right and what's wrong in the previous books. So the Quran came to have authority and to be like the one in charge of the other previous books. The other point that Allah is saying in this verse, فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ, judge between them, Muhammad, the Jews, the Christian, the Muslims, according what Allah had revealed to you. Not according their laws. Okay? Because for every nation, Allah make what? A different Sharia. So no one today can come and say, I'm going to live by the Bible, or I'm going to pray according what is written in the Old Testament. You can pray until the day of the judgment is not going to help you, because you have to pray according the way the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam show us. The book of Moses, good for the time of Moses. The book of Jesus, good for the time of Jesus. Okay? After the coming of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, jazakallah khair. After the coming of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you could not judge or worship by any other book other than what been revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the second way of distinguish between the prophets, who do you follow? We believe in all of them, we love all of them, we respect all of them, but we only go by the teaching of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Thank you for being with us here. May Allah keep us on the Sirat al-Mustaqim, give us the correct understanding about our deen and our aqeedah. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك and Allah knows best.